The doctors I speak with now are ready to see professionalism not as involving their total autonomy and independence from accountability, but more as an opportunity for them to develop meaningful relationships, not just with their patients, not just with their families, but with their community and beyond, to really improve the health of the public.
We work with a community-based organization called the San Ysidro Community Health Center. And what they try to do is make sure that they integrate the family perspective into the care delivery. So for one example, they had an child who kept coming in and who was overweight and was experiencing health problems because of that issue. It turns out that there was a grandmother at home who had not been involved in the care and who was telling them to go against that advice. So that health center worked, and the health professionals there worked to incorporate that grandmother's perspective into the care delivery. And ultimately, they were able to get onto a schedule, get onto sort of a regimen that allowed that child access to good health advice that that the parents were willing to follow.
Medicine has typically focused on delivering health care. The broader view of professionalism includes a focus on health. So for example, if I have a patient who has diabetes and is overweight, and I say, well, let's talk about an exercise program. The patient says to me, well, I'd like to go walking, but there's so much gun violence in my neighborhood, it's not safe. I could say, oh, that's too bad, well, maybe you could go walk somewhere else. Or I could take it upon myself as a physician, working with other physicians, working with community partners, to say, what can we do about the safety in that neighborhood? Or I may go to a school board meeting and sit in on, as the school board talks about fast food policy in the schools. Should they have healthy snacks in the vending machines or chips and soda? That doesn't seem like a sort of traditional physician role yet. If you think about moving from health care as a primary focus to health, you recognize that physicians have a lot of expertise and a lot of inherent leadership skills, and I believe an obligation to step into that realm and try and advocate for the health of the population.
There are gaps for many different reasons within the Latino community. There is a lack of cultural competency often, and a lack of understanding about the community, their cultural practices, and potentially even language barriers between the community and physicians. And so we're working every day to make sure that those gaps are closed through greater access to training for physicians, but also bringing greater health literacy and education into the community so that they can be empowered to take care of their own health.
It seems like all of the power and authority for the health of a population has been diverted to government or to insurers or to employers. And what I've been learning in the past 3 years is when a physicians, either singularly or as a group, go to those power brokers, if you will, and begin to have a candid conversation about what's good for patients, who in fact are their employees or their clients, suddenly we can have a meeting of the minds that delivers a better care and a better system. That's not something that's part of the medical professional culture. Or at least it wasn't part of the culture I grew up in. It's something that must become a part of the culture. So quite frankly, advocacy for quality of care is an essential part of contemporary medical professionalism.